Okay, you ready? This is class number four, beginning lindy hop, and we did some solo footwork. So we added on to what we were doing before with this little turn. So we did a rock, step, triple step, 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 triple, focusing, keeping arms out to the side for balance, and keeping your legs kind of bent, your knees bent so that you're rooted down to the ground as you're doing this little triple step around. And then we also did a mess around. So the mess around looks like this. We just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We can do it the other way, 5, 6, 7. There's not a lot of technique in that one. It's just kind of shaking your butt around in a circle. And we did it in these counts. So we went 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the back to this thing, 4, 5, da, da, da. Just practicing moving in a circle. And then we got to swing outs tonight, so a bit to talk about here, but we're gonna make it kind of quick. So we started out familiar to count four. We started in closed here, closed position, familiar to count four, because you guys have done this with your promenades or other moves. And then on count five here, in order to swing your partner out leads, you wanna make sure your foot, your hip, your hand, everything goes down the line behind you, your partner with it on that 5, 6, 7, 8. Here, as we move down the line, you want to make sure it follows that you go all the way to the end. So we talked about the end being this place where we both have a little bend in our arms. We're not overextended. We're not super close to each other, but we're kind of at the end of this little rope. If we think about our arms just being ropes with a little bit of a bend in it, so it's comfortable. When we end in this place, the next thing we did was go from open position, where we've got some space, back to closed position. Sometimes we call it a lindy circle. And in order to get into that circle, if we're in this place where we have this taut rope between us, we did this exercise where if I start walking back as a lead, Erin's gonna come forward whenever she feels it. So, for example, if we start here where we have a loose rope, we wait till that rope gets taut and then the follow move. So it's that, we sort of zoomed in on that moment, but that moment happens every time we do a swing out. There's gonna be a little bit of a lag between moving back and Erin coming forward. So then to do this lindy circle, I move back and I try to get Erin moving forward on that count one. So that's gonna be different follows for what you're used to. So just kind of check yourself and make sure that if you feel that momentum forward, you just try not to pull that step back, but instead just let yourself move forward. By all means, if you're dancing and you feel that rock step, do it. But try to get yourself out of the muscle memory habit of always doing a rock step for the follows. So here we've got this. A 1, 2, 3, and 4. And here we did something called a lindy circle. We just kept moving in a circle and wrapped it up at the end. So we talked about a couple things that help this. One is if the follows continue through that 3 and 4, the momentum, as if there's energy, we'll show you where here, here. So Erin's dancing as if there's energy going through her back in that direction, and that way we don't cut off the momentum here. And then we also practice this idea of if you need to, you can cross over just a little bit in this circle. Both people go, leads and follows, go right over left, and that helps you to move in a circle and actually stay square to your partner, versus if everyone's just walking straight sometimes, we get in this funny position here, which is not what we're aiming for. So if we start an open again, it looks like this. We've got 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7. So the whole thing together, once again, looks like this. We've got 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and then back to close, 3, and 4, 5, 6. And just remember, you've got lots of other tools in the tool bag, so make sure that in between those, I think it's nice to just do some of those forward and back or whatever it is to kind of reset. And we also talked about how it might be handy when you're practicing these, instead of trying to think of all 10 things we just mentioned, maybe think about one thing, kind of work that thing over and over, and then choose a new thing the next couple times you practice. Is that it? Okay, thanks guys. We'll put on some music for you to practice.